Well, I think it definitely is important for us because this shows that the people around the world is really supporting us, and I think it really gives us a lot of hope that that Hong Kong can. It gives us a lot of hope that Hong Kong can finally return to a peaceful city, and that people living in Hong Kong can really get what they want, like democracy and stopping the police brutality and things like that. And I think the support from international city is great. I mean, we really hope that the international Indonesian can support us, because only us Hong Kongers and the protesters can cannot just fight with a huge party like the Communist Party. I hope they can make some sort of like a list that punishes people that negatively affects the situation in Hong Kong and the democracy in Hong Kong. Because we are so surrounded by police, and the police said if we don't leave here, we'll be charged with riots, but the police just surrounded here and we just can't leave. We don't know how to go back home, and we don't know what we can really do now. So we just build from the SOS to tell the world that we are just surrounded and we don't know what we can really do next. Because the police, first of all, if we just go out, we'll probably be arrested and charged with riots, and we're afraid of that, and we're afraid of the prison. Even though some of us really didn't really do anything, we just can't even stay here. Yeah, we're afraid of that. And the second thing is that we are afraid that the police when the police see us, they will beat us up or something like that.
So you're afraid of the what the police will do, what kind of the force they will do?
Yeah, the violence.
The violence.
I think this is to thank the U.S. that the U.S. passed the act, and we want to thank them. So we raise the U.S. flag. We hope that the world can know the situation in Hong Kong and don't trust the Chinese Communist Party, and especially Taiwan. Don't trust them.